everyone is doing well. Thank you very much to E4M for inviting me, and have really appreciated the sessions this morning. Really nice to hear some of the practitioners share their thinking, and hopefully you will hear confirmation of some of the themes you've heard, and hopefully you hear something new as well in the session today. Let me start with a video that sets a little bit of context and also sort of captures how we are looking at the opportunity of data and AI. This is a topic very close to my heart, and through the session, what I'd like to share with you is how data and AI can be a growth driver for consumer markets.
There's an Uber 3 minutes away.
Give me a number, I'll add
you
to the WhatsApp group.
You know that
last one? Okay, it's Kickstarter just lost Alexa.
My daughter can't stop using TikTok. She thinks she's a real life.
Give me a number, I'll add you to WhatsApp. There's a new one. It kept on net on the nasal.
Tomorrow, instead of Christmas Day being devoted just to family, a record number of people are expected to be shopping online.
Around us, data is the soil oil for the AI, and we are using it every day, everywhere, and in all honesty, sometimes we may be using it without even realizing we're using it, right? How many of us? First thing I do in the morning is I check on the Maps app. What is the quickest way to get to office? How do I avoid the traffic this morning in Mumbai? Or I come back home in the evening, I have to do some shopping, and I'm seeing these recommendations, and I say, hey, this looks like an interesting product that I can purchase. Or what about this great new show on Netflix or one of the other platforms that I might, you know, see to wind down? Someone's mentioning chatbots. How many of us are using chatbots to, you know, really do the things that we need to, which earlier required human interfaces? So AI is all around us, we're using it, and in our market, this is definitely being accelerated by the Digital India stack, the penetration that we are seeing of digital all around us. We have, as we also heard this morning, high smartphone penetration, one of the most affordable costs of data in the world. And this is absolutely complemented by the increased internet penetration that we're seeing in the country, right? And so our consumers who are there in this geography are buying more online. They are exploring trends online. They are coming back and connecting with like-minded people on social and sharing their feedback, and they're sharing what they would like to see more online. The retailers, right? And we shop online, but we also significantly still shop offline in this part of the world. And we have about 10 million retailers all across the country, from our modern trade large format stores to the small kirana stores, right? And our retailers are not really being left behind in this digital revolution as well. They are participating in this digital economy. What are my consumers interested in? What are the trends that they are looking at? And so they are consuming a lot of brand and product information online as well. And so for companies like us, AI and data and technology become an incredible opportunity. They become an incredible opportunity across all our ecosystems, our consumers, people who are buying and using our products, our customers, so we're manufacturers, our customers are the retailers in this country. So how are they, you know, having the right product on shelf? And ultimately, all of this is going to be possible with speed and accuracy when we are imbibing all principles of Industry 4.0 and digitizing all aspects of our operations. So let me share with you a few examples of how we in Hindustan Unilever are doing this. So let me start with one of my favorite examples, right? So all around the world of beauty and how we're leveraging beauty to drive digital experience. So in HUL, we have a number of beauty brands, right, which are embedded into the day-to-day of so many consumers that we have. So this could be Expertise Hair Solutions from Tresemme, Expert Skincare from Dove, or looking runway ready with Lakme. We are helping our consumers look good, feel good every day and everywhere. Now, a lot of these consumers are going digital, so we have to be able to have seamless digital experiences so that they're able to experience the brand in the accessible comfort of their own home, right? And so we have a number of examples like virtual try-ons, recommendation engines, even interactive quizzes to help consumers select down to the products that are of relevance to them, and really be able to see some of this in the, you know, comfort of their own home in the same impactful way as they would have an experience in the store or in the salon. Moving on, we talked a lot about how media and content are really getting augmented, and I absolutely agree. I think data and AI is really positively augmenting, positively disrupting this space. And in HUL, we are seeing this as a really big enabler and a big sort of shift that we have to sort of also partner and lead as we are going forward. So we look at this from, you know, machine learning and analytics helping us invest in the right channels, so where our customers are going, where our consumers are going, so that we are present there. Looking at AI augmentation in the whole generation of content, the content ecosystem, the content supply chain is going to be so much bigger because we're going to have so many more variants of content all coming out much faster. And how do we therefore leverage all of this data and AI to ensure that we have the right message going to the right person, the right consumer, at the right place, at the right time, and not do it once, not do it twice, but do it every time so that we have the right presence of mind for our brands, with our consumers, and we ensure that we are helping them get the best out of life. One of the interesting examples of data and AI, and this one is something that we've been working on for the past few years, is not just about helping the digital experience for our consumers and helping them purchase, but it's also about how do we use data and AI to be able to create the right products and the right product innovation. So we have this agile innovation model that we've been working on. And for those of you who understand CPG and understand product innovation in a CPG space, right? Traditionally, it is a sequential, iterative, and human-intensive process. So we have a lot of consumer research, a lot of engagement with consumers, a lot of work that our scientists do, and all of that works iteratively in a traditional sense that used to be able to, there'd be many months and then we would have that innovation in the market. But today, with data, AI, technology, automation, a lot of those new tech trends that are coming in, we are seeing those cycles can be crashed. They can be substantially crashed and they can go from months to weeks, yeah? So where we are doing this, we're looking at the wealth of data that we have from our consumers, that we have from social sentiment analysis, to be able to understand what trends are coming in. We're able to use machine learning to be able to identify and shortlist what are those trends that we want to sort of pick up and build products on and do that fast. We have generative AI that can come in and help us create multiple variations of concepts so that we can work much faster to be able to bottom out, converge into what our product is going to look like. In silico design, where you can actually work, iterate on product formulations in an efficient manner, and definitely having digital twins, having 3D printing, all of these kind of capabilities that allow you to scale manufacturing with speed and with accuracy. And with using range of tech, data, and analytics, we've then been able to really sort of cut down the time it takes for us to pick up on a trend, to be able to land a trend. And I think this is a really exciting area that will be one of the big emerging areas, I believe, in the coming years on how we leverage technology to drive growth. Now, one of the things that we talked about consumer, how we get them the right product, how we get them the right communication, how we help them on the purchase journey, right? But what happens when the consumer is purchasing offline? Omnichannel journeys are very much here to stay. This is something that is becoming a bigger and bigger trend for our consumers and in our market. We see a lot of them search, shortlist, explore online, and then they come to the store to shop, right? The last mile is in the store. But what happens that, you do all of it and then you go to your store and actually the product is not there? That is going to really sort of disappoint the customer. So in a market where we have around 10 million sort of shops that are there, so points of purchase, and for us at HUL, probably have 70-75% of our sales still going through traditional trade or the small kirana stores. I think it's really important to help them navigate this era of e-com, quick-com, and really enable them also to be able to continue to help and create impactful experiences for their own shoppers and customers. So Shikhar, our eB2B app, is what we use to be able to do that, to connect with our customers, to shortlist, give them recommendations, much like we see e-com are doing, and we use a wealth of data and AI behind that to recommend assortment. We use computer vision to be able to help them order very, very quickly instead of going through the painstaking process of saying what's on shelf, how much do I have, how much do I need, and you know, really make it efficient for them. And we saw a couple of these examples. We partnered with Arshad Varsi to be able to create a campaign for the number of our stores, I think over 1.3 million stores that we have on Shikhar. And they were able to create their own sort of video to invite their customers to come to their store and shop. And in fact, this was a really exciting campaign, Gen AI-based campaign, where I think when we launched it, we had a new video created once every 10 seconds. And that is a phenomenal number. Now, as we've been doing this, and these are not the only examples that we have, but you know, some of the exciting ones that I thought I'd share today. But I also wanted to sort of come back and say, what are some of the lessons that we've learned and some of the underlying principles that we use? And I think the first one is really about leverage AI where it matters. It's the shiny new toy. We can do many things with it, but what is really going to create impact for your business and what is the business outcome that you want to drive? Really important, I think, for us to know that. The second is within your organization, create a culture to leverage AI. You need sponsorship and you need adoption, and people need to understand and be able to embrace this. And that's, I think, really important. And finally, you need data. So don't, with the AI program, forget that you really need a data program to underpin it. And that is truly the foundation for great insights and recommendations. And lastly, all of this needs to be underpinned by digital trust. Really important when you are storing and caretaking data that belongs to your consumers, your customers, you have to do it with care. And you know, as we are doing this, let's also look at AI from a responsible AI lens. Really important to test your algorithms, test the data sets that you're using to ensure that AI does not have bias, it is transparent, and it does not, it really helps you achieve the outcome that you want. So it says time's up. And so thank you very much, and I hope that session was very useful.